the music, huh?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Welcome back. You spilled your Skittles? This is gonna be fucking miserable already. My God. How's your day?
Fantastic. How was yours?
It's payday, so we got money for a couple hours at least.
Until I find more wedding stuff to buy.
Yeah, that's for sure. Boy, we're previewing D5 tonight. Sign's backwards, just like it was last night. That's how you treat Sprocket? You don't even know how to get the damn sign right?
Or we're using a different camera.
Poor Sprocket.
Tonight and last night. And I don't know how to, like, I don't know if you can flip the orientation.
I think you're a dog hater is what it is you are.
I love dogs, you know that.
Dad, you're the one that hates dogs.
My app's not even working.
Dad.
I got a trauma.
Yes.
Oh, air horn app. Fuck yes.
Oh my God.
All right. Man, we had some awesome guests the last couple of minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for Selena and Troy Hansen for stopping on by. Tucker and Bradley, of course. And last night, Paul Rosner. I know you missed some of that, taking our producer dance. But
what
did you take away from Paul last night? Anything in particular for the time you were here?
I like his etiquette suggestions for everybody. I think those need to be followed. I think you should make a sign, hang it up at deck, actually. No?
Like,
just deck hockey etiquette, clean up after yourself, be polite. Don't be a douchebag fan.
Hmm.
Don't bring the horns, Mark.
I'm not bringing the horns, just, well, in Paul's games now I will. But otherwise, I'll behave.
Yeah.
I don't know. It just comes with the territory. I mean, it's hockey. That's the way people get passionate. People get passionate playing deck. Like, you turn into a different person.
Oh, yeah.
And then outside of deck, they're normal. It's like, well, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
What I took away from Paul is, if we were on fire, he would piss on us, so that's nice. You know? It would be an honor, Mr. Rosner. I'm on fire. Please pee on me, you know? Right? Because he literally said,
you're supposed to stop, drop, and roll, not have somebody else pee on you.
I understand that, but he's also helping out. I mean, he wouldn't do that for others, the way it sounds of it.
Maybe he wouldn't do that for others.
He pretty much said there was people that he wouldn't piss on if they were on fire. He'd walk away and he'd sleep good at night. It's generally what he said.
Oh, so, Lord.
It's kind of funny because before in the morning, yeah, good time to run the water.
I know.
Fuck.
Stop cussing.
Oh boy.
Yes, what we wanted to do for show prep.
That's cute.
That is cute. I was like, I didn't know how to answer that. I'm like, being on time? No, we have a show meeting at 4:30, followed by makeup and lighting after. And then we just go over every team with a fine comb. He's so prepared. I remember he came to our fantasy draft. You know, he had a ruler and every notes on every nick and neck player, and I came in there with a piece of notebook paper and felt like a fool.
I'm sure he paid a professional as well, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
How's that working out for him? We should have asked him that last night.
Well, the profession he paid, I think, sprays Febreze in his helmet, and that's why he's losing hair.
Oh!
But anyway, I digress. But great, he had such great information. I still haven't even watched it myself. I can't wait to watch it.
Because
I know I'm going to learn something again. He's welcome anytime. Hanson's a welcome anytime. Selena, she's a book on some of those rosters, as was Troy. So, but no guests tonight, just the two of us, because it's Friday night. Wearing the Bandit shirt. Check out that Stacey, even if you're not a Bandits fan, check out that Bandits video Stacey Plum did on Facebook. It'll make you want to just take someone in the corner Sunday, smash their head against a fence, you know, and you're playing. Yeah, it gets you going.
Opening night.
Opening night. You want to let them know right away that.
Did she use some of her, like, headbanging music?
She did.
Okay.
It was really incredible, well done, though.
Hmm.
You'll have to watch.
I will.
Yeah.
I saw it, but didn't have time to watch it yet, so.
You saw it.
I saw, as I was flipping through Facebook, I saw the little thing scroll by. And I didn't have time to stop and look at it, but now I will.
Okay.
Yeah.
What I want to talk about D5 is mainly becoming a co-ed league, you know, well, it always has been, but more so, it seems like. Excuse me. But, man, the girls in co-ed are phenomenal. I was talking to Jack Copeland, actually brought this up. I don't understand why there's a rule still that you have five females total and five males.
Like no more,
no more than five.
Yeah, I think that's stupid.
I don't know. Is that standard in the rest of deck period? Like, you go to other areas, is that just a standard rule, or is that something here?
I don't know.
Because, do you remember the She Devils?
Yep. They were all women.
Yes, they
Except
were.
Except Peter. Wasn't
yeah,
Peter
at,
on
at
it?
The end, they used Mados. Yeah.
You didn't need me for a while, right?
What's that?
You didn't need me for a while, right?
No, we don't need you for a while. We'll let you know. Thank you for producing. Well done. Do you want me to give you a head? You know, hey, we need you or something?
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
Hi.
Thanks for your time.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm trying to watch.
The She-Devils, I remember them. They were D3 open. Because that was the league that was made for them at the time to allow that. They were just over their heads in that particular league. And it wasn't anything that the girls were talented.
They had a good team.
It was just the wrong league. When you're going up against the Dylan Idols, the Zach Orwigs, the Brian Wordens at that time, Brendan Smith, that's hard for any, you know, girl to compete at that level. So, I mean, you know what I mean, that day in and day out.
Yeah.
I would like to see another She-Devils team. Like, if that particular team would have gone down to D4, if they were allowed to play D4 or D5+, they would have been competitive.
Yeah.
At that time, if there was a D5+. I mean, luckily, Wood was in D3 open, so they had someone they could beat, but...
Oh. Jeez. Throwing darts a little early, aren't you?
I'm tired.
Yeah.
These shows, man. Nelson owes me a bunch for driving traffic to the site. Drive traffic to the site. We need it. But, so, I mean, eventually I'd like to see it because it seems like, I would guess we have more female players playing, you know, deck than maybe the majority of the country, I bet.
You think so?
I'm just guessing. There's
what? There is a Women's Ball Hockey Federation, like, website.
Well, that's what I'm saying I want to get to, too, is, like, we have, you know, our D1 players, you know, form Team USAs that travel around. Our junior leagues have been doing that, and they'll go up to Canada and perform it very well. Why not? Maybe there is. I'm just not aware. Like, a Women's Federation. You know, like, I know we have some ladies here that could... vie for a few spots on that team for sure.
Well, okay, so do you know Lowe? What's her last name? Stern from Chicago. And I want to say Nikki. I shouldn't say it because I don't know if it's true, but I thought Nikki was on it.
Okay.
And they actually do, like, they play on the Chicago team who plays for this Women's Ball Hockey Federation.
That's what I'd like to see. I think women's here's just exploding, and the talent is just phenomenal. And, like Jack was saying, he wouldn't trade any of his girls on his team for nothing. And I got to thinking, in all the years I've played with any girl, whether it be Mackenzie Batten or Amanda Wiseman or whoever, I wouldn't trade any of them for nobody. What? Or Courtney McDermott, for sure.
I'm just playing out here. Anyways.
But... because I would take any of them in a heartbeat before I would take someone that's new to the game that's a guy, because they've already know what they're doing. They play the game. Sometimes they got to transition their game, just like if I move up to D3, I want to play defense, and I'm just trying to spell the better guys so they get some rest for a little bit. Some of these girls are used to scoring big time in WD2, WD3. When they transition to 5+ or D4, then it's kind of a different game for them where they have set different roles where they were maybe the star in that league. But I don't know. I mean, I'm not looking to start an argument. I know that was created for Athena and all that, but I'd like, I don't see why not. I have no problem getting beat by 10 girls. I don't. Those girls from Chicago did laps around me.
Like, really rude to them. Like,
well, bad. I understand that. That goes back to etiquette.
Yeah.
Big time. Treat everybody the same.
I've seen it too. They don't like us girls playing in their sport.
Wow. More power to them for playing the sport.
I'm not doing co-ed this year, actually.
No, you're not doing co-ed. Not even if I need you to sub, huh?
Well, I could do yours.
Oh, well, that's different.
It is. Because I want to play with you. But...
Well, thank you.
That's why I'm not on a team this year.
Well, then we just got to get past that because they're all talented. And I've never had a problem with any of their attitudes. You know, you would think some of them. Just like anybody, we all get whiny if we're not on the power play or whatever, you know, or set different roles. And
it's 2021, except the women on the COVIDs.
That's what I'd like to see. Like I said, those girls from Chicago did laps around me when they come down. They never stop moving. Aislinn, I still have nightmares of Aislinn scoring 6 goals in a game, and I might have been out there for 5 of the 6.
Oh my god.
She did stuff
like that. I want talent like that. I want to be able to go out there and do that. So bad. Well,
it takes a lot of years in practice, but that's my rant for the day. I would love to see another Sheep Devils team without Mados on it. And I could go probably give you a top 10 new Sheep Devils, but I'm not going to do that because the ones that are not in a bitch. Hey, Mark fucking hates my game. That's not true. Because you want your scores, but you want girls to play defense too. And you know what I mean? You don't just pick the 10 best scorers.
Right. Yeah.
So.
Yeah, don't do that because you defend a lot of people, probably including me. So.
Exactly. That's why I'm not doing it. Not on a Friday night. I mean, I need to sleep upstairs. That's a lot. Not on the couch. Yeah. Especially when you got family coming. That looks pretty bad.
It would. Yeah.
One correction. Excuse me. Dylan Arndt. Well, it's not a correction. Dylan Arndt is a goal for Domino's D3.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I love that kid. I love his maturity. I love his game. Yeah, he quiet and goes about it the right way. I think I fucked him up at the end of the year, though, because I scored on him in a shootout and got in his head a little bit. You know, you
feel,
got jittery after that. It's like, oh, fuck. But,
yeah.
No, I love that kid. He saved our season, essentially, for Benders there at the end of the season, because TJ Lampkin came. You know, was hurt. I'm not sure he's back this year. I haven't seen him on the roster, unfortunately. And he's a stud player and a goalie.
Yeah.
So, good luck.
He must have really screwed it up.
Must have, because every team would want a TJ Lampkin.
Mm-hmm.
He's won nine cups, I think, last I talked to him.
Wow.
He's quite an unassuming guy.
Jeez.
There's a lot of people that won more than me. A lot of people. And now we're all going to win less. Because we got the long season instead of short season, you know, you could really rack them up. Thank God, now I'm thanking the long season because we don't have to do a fall preview.
The fans are thanking us. Thank you as well for that.
Absolutely. So let's get into D5 and just fucking tear it up.
Okay.
I didn't mean to spit. Go ahead. You want to play the music or what? Fuck.
Yeah. Well, our producer kicked me off of my job. Okay.
There are many people who drink in moderation with no problems, social, moral, or medical. They have learned to enjoy liquor without letting it upset the functioning of their body and mind. It relaxes you, makes you more congenial.
I just had one.
This helps make a gathering cheerful and friendly.
It ain't my fault, so don't blame me. I swear I just came here to unwind and have one drink. The way it looks ain't what you think. This Cabernet has a way of vanishing on me. There's a hole in the bottle, leaking all this wine. It's already empty, it ain't even supper time. I ain't no.
Thank you, Kelsey. Thank you. Thank you so much. check out that video.
You're already in trouble today, dude. Come on.
I just want people to enjoy a good time. Yeah. That's a phenomenal video. The choreography, the dancing, phenomenal. She's a rising star. You played Luke Bryan, right? Why can't I have a little candy?
I didn't talk about him like that.
You would have. We sat in the front row of one of his shows and let him shake his ass in your face. But, oh, I played Kelsey. You know, hell breaks loose. 14 teams in D5.
No wonder we didn't do
what?
WD2
tonight, too. Oh, yeah. WD2, we're doing another day. I'll get to that later. But, you know, D5, there's talent. There's athletic talent because you get a lot of kids that play other sports that are new to deck hockey. Like I said, we're going like co-ed. You get some crossover from the ladies coming around. Now, what are you doing? Man. I mean, there's talent there. People knock D5. It's still not easy. And it's a lot more running because there's more dumping and chasing. It wears me the hell out. Yeah. Wears me the hell out running around like that. But you're going to see plenty of talent. You're going to see names that you go, oh, yeah, that person's good. So how about we fucking get into it, huh?
Sounds good.
Hey, so we enjoy our weekend. The champs. And Archie D5, do you remember them? They beat
absolutely
our ass in the finals.
I do.
Woo! Good times. Yep. Good times. The Rocket is back.
Is he going to do his bear curl this year?
Hey, he does it all. Does it all. Welcome back. Our former guest, Troy Hansen, is actually on the team. You mentioned that. And Donnie Heseltine, he's got that beard, man. He's a great player. That's a great pickup for them. They lost Daniel Keith, of course, because he moved up to, he got his rank, he moved up.
Thank God.
Well deserved. Mm-hmm. Well deserved. He was shutting people down. This is going to be the longest show ever. You keep that up.
What, you just ignore when I get emails? And
how about you just turn the fucking thing off?
Okay.
This is a quality program.
You don't want me to control
the got Paul Reisner on here last night. We were moving up the fucking ranks. Right? I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. You're fueled by Jesus and coffee. Number two, DC Yetis. Of course, we've been talking about their social media and the stuff they get.
Guys, come on. I'm not made to be a meme.
It was funny.
No,
it was pretty
embarrassing.
Good. It was pretty good. I want to talk about Dale Dickingall. Is there a harder worker at deck?
Yeah,
Dale?
Yeah.
He's been grinding it all winter because I've seen him in Buffalo. Not only does he go the days on there, he goes like the other ones, like with Crystal and Haley and, you know, his other teams. He works his ass off. I don't think he ever turns down a chance to sub. Mm-mm. Like, he just works.
Yep.
Incredible work ethic.
And working third shift, how does he even have the energy to do that?
Yeah, I don't know. Especially working with Nelson, because he probably got to do all Nelson's work. Sam Schertz, McKenzie, of course.
Who's McKenzie?
Daughter, right?
Oh, yeah. She plays.
I'm afraid to say that anymore ever since the Copeland incident, but I'm fairly certain that's correct.
I don't think you offended anybody with that.
No, I didn't, but I strived for accuracy. Mm-hmm. Unlike my shot. Not accurate. Josh Woodham, Phil Bittner. This is going to be yet another solid team. They were the Mighty Decks last year, you know, but now they're, you know, they got the Yetis going. I think even the team in Waterloo is going to be called the Yetis. So it's spreading like wildfire.
Like after Sasquatch the Yeti or after like the coolers and cups?
Well, they got Sasquatch on their front,
they?
I believe. Yeah. Okay. They'll let us know.
Yeah.
We're being the newest meme. These two fucking people don't know what a Yeti is.
There was your meme.
Yeah. Can't wait. Yeah, we deserve it. If we're going to sit here and yammer for an hour.
True.
About everybody else, I can take a little heat. Maybe. But they were damn good last year. They've really done well in D5 last year, and the year before they were solid.
Is Vane not on that team this year?
Man, I didn't pull up their roster. Well, I did. I don't know if he's rated too. He might be rated too high. He might just be managing the team.
Okay.
He'll let us know.
He played last year.
Sean Bain's a phenomenal player. That's what I want to say. Thank you. The Yetis and Culligan, basically the same organization. Between lines 1 and 3, like, there's no drop-off. They could mix and match any of those players on any of those teams. I don't think it matters.
No.
There's never a drop-off. Like, from 1 to 9 players, it's solid as fuck all the time. Because some teams, they usually got 1 or 2 solid lines. That third, you know, the third line you might be able to score on or take advantage of. And it's not with that. I mean, they used to roll, like, Ryan and Sam shirts on the third line. I mean, Jesus.
I know. So I never looked forward to playing that team.
Number 3. Should I get my air horn for this? Huh?
Might as well. Go turn your volume on.
That was stupid. How about this? Are you
I
ready?
I could have done it while you said that.
Are you fucking ready for this?
Yeah.
Woo! Oh, too far. Woo! Raise it up. Let me hear you out there.
I got a crotch shot. That was nice.
They get a crotch shot. Boom! We just dropped a Pocky Mala, yeah. The BD fucking Bandits. Make some noise!
Woo!
Woo! Woo!
Bandit family.
How about this? Let's sit back because I'm about to go on a rant.
Uh-oh.
We lost a player.
You are in trouble. With a capital T?
Well, I don't think you know the whole story.
I mean, I know who it is. I guess I don't know.
No, you don't. But I'm about to tell you because... What the... See, this is what happens when I turn on the volume. Hold on. Aw. Thank you, Mitch Seifer, for the positive words. Where was I? Yeah, we lost that player. Yeah. I'm just going to go ahead and tell you the whole story.
Okay, good.
Because I think it's good for everybody. It's your favorite player. Who you were described to be. It's Lindsay Womack, and we lost her. But this is the true story. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Well, I was at the end of the year, about December-ish, you know, I was barged into Stacy's office, and I said, you know, Stacy Plum, and I said, Jesus Christ, Stacy, we gotta do something fucking different, you know, we lost all these cups. Thankfully, D1 bailed us out. I go, I'll stick around, but we need to do something. Stacey's like, yeah, we need to do something big within the organization to make a statement, right? And she gave me this story about, you know how there's like a Bob in the office, but he's successful as fuck. Like, he's always big in sales. He's the party guy. People love him. You know, he can go around and slap people on the asses, like, ha, 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 but if I did it, I'd be held in handcuffs, you know. Yeah. He's allowed, like, to bang the guy's wives, you know, right? Yeah, go ahead, take her home, Bob. Give her a good time. Thank you. It'd be an honor. It'd be an honor, Bob. But then you get around to this company, they gotta make cuts, right? Because everybody else is mediocre. And they want to cut somebody. To make a statement.
So they cut Bob.
Oh, no!
Okay.
Yeah. This is my fucking story.
Sorry.
This is going to be a good story in that fucking though. So, yeah. They essentially cut Bob and they fire him.
Okay.
So.
I don't think this person was cut, though.
Will you listen? I'm telling you the damn story.
Sorry.
So they cut Bob. You know, everything's sad. He's walking out like there's a little cardboard box, you know, and everybody's going, my God, I can't believe they did that to Bob. Well, Stacy's like, we got to make a statement, team, that mediocrity will not be accepted within the Bandits organization, right?
Okay. That's why I'm not invited.
I'm like, well, okay, well, what do you want to do, you know? And she's like, let's cut Lindsay Womack. And I'm like, are you serious? And she's like, yeah, let's cut her. Because she's won a cup. She's the hardest worker. But we got to make an example out of somebody. Right? That way everybody pays more attention and they turn their games up and say, hey, you know, they can do this to Stacy or Lindsay. They can do this to any of us. Like, I could be out that window, you know. You know, Chewy could be gone. He might not even get his RV or microwave that he wants. So, I slept out for a night. Because, man, that's just one of my favorite players. I'm like, Stacy's right. We got to do something.
Okay.
So, I said, let's do it. So, we brought Lindsay in. And we cut her. And she wasn't happy about it, of course. She would be. She's like, where am I going to go? Country Financial Pickles? Deckheads? Well, I mean, what do you want me to do? I said, this is what we got to do. It's an organizational deal. We're sorry. And we wish you the best of luck on your future endeavors, you know, wherever you may be. And she basically told me to take an escalator, you know, an elevator all the way down to the bottom. So I guess that means go to hell. She didn't take it well. But sometimes you got to do that within an organization.
Okay.
So, I'm sorry I'm going to miss her, but I wish her the best of luck. So, that's that. That's the story on Lindsay Womack. I miss her so much. I miss her so much.
Aww.
I miss her so much. Anyways, we replaced her with Terry Smith. I don't even know the girl. I've talked to her a couple times on Messenger, so, you know, and I can tell you right now, I like her attitude. Do you need to get the dog?
I probably should.
Go ahead, why?
Terry Smith is going to be on my team this year.
She's going to be on your team as well. I've never met her, I don't think.
I haven't either. I don't know who she is.
No, but from what I hear, she's a grinder, a hard worker. Yeah. Danny Sachocli's on the team, of course, and she's been a loyal bandit. Here's the heavy hitters, though. Don't be coming over here with your slobber. We got Lucy. I'm so proud of my fucking self.
That is pretty awesome.
It was in a Buffalo practice, and I hear Shane, her husband, and he goes, yeah, she's rated D5. And I about stopped in my tracks. And I thought about that the whole night. I'm like, there's no way she's rated D5. Sure enough, she is. And I'm like, well, I'll go ask her. But I guess she's on.
How is she only D5?
10 teams.
Freaking awesome.
Well, she is freaking amazing. Wow. But that's the way it works out sometimes with the scoring and stuff. So I go and ask. And sure enough, she joined us. And I couldn't be prouder. I could be prouder myself. This is the kind of people that I'm talking about yesterday. Like, I worry we weren't bringing enough new talent in.
Mm-hmm. Well, she's not new anymore, but yes, we...
Yeah, I mean new to the band's organization. Oh, she never played for the Bandits. Yeah. Well, I said we were getting, you know, possibly... I worry about getting complacent.
Yeah.
Because we brought in some people last year that performed well. But there's a couple we didn't do our research on. Like, we thought maybe this guy played offense when we were told he played offense when he actually plays defense. And, you know, when that kind of stuff happens, you already got D-men. It's... Anyways, Rob Kidsenbaugh.
Who's that?
He played for Japan in the past, and he's with Bush Lightning, too.
Okay.
Phenomenal D-man. He's got a heavy slap shot. I'm so happy to have him on board. Lindsay Schmidt, she played with Nightshades last year, but
yep. She
packed her bags. I love Lindsay Schmidt's defense. She is a prototypical player. You look at her stats and say, why would I play her in co-ed?
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely play her in co-ed. Yes, she stops everything. She sees the court so well. Not everybody has to score, you know. Everybody's got roles, different roles. Why are you rolling your head? Stacy Plum's like that. Why does she need to score? She plays awesome D. She makes the right pass. Not everybody's there to score.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I.
What?
drink, but
that's it. Well, everybody wishes they could, but accept your role if you can't. Mm-hmm. And this, the reason we started this team to come back to D5 was Chris Langley is going to be on goal in his first year on goal. Everything that guy does is 100%. Like I told him, we have 7 months. This goes for any goalie. You have 7 months this year to improve. If your April and May is bad, keep improving. There's plenty of games. And we brought in son Elliot for a little youth because, well, me and Bob are on the team. So, thank you. I love Bob. He's actually an incredible teammate. You know, everybody plays against him. Hates playing against him for the most part.
He's such a good guy, you guys.
Yeah, but he's a teddy bear. Mm-hmm.
I call him a goon when I play against him on the deck, but off the deck, he's cool.
And I want to talk about Stacy. Everybody probably thinks Stacy's this, like, maniac, like she's overzealous because she runs all these teams. They've had so much success. She delegates almost everything. Mm-hmm. Like,
I've noticed that.
Chevy Albee basically ran his own team. Right, you know, her son Ryan runs a couple of teams. Mm-hmm. She delegates Nathan Joyce and Paul Reisner 4+. She's given me some responsibility at times, which I passed on to Lindsay, but Lindsay's gone. And last year was Lindsay's fault because I passed on to her, so. But that's the thing, and she'll let you make mistakes. I can see in her eyes sometimes I'll say something like, let's do this and that, and I can tell she probably doesn't agree with it. Mm-hmm. And she won't. Sometimes she'll say something, but most times she'll just get that look like, yeah, you screwed up, but, you know, it's okay. But she doesn't get enough credit for delegating. That's what a good leader does, mm-hmm. is delegate. And her advice is invaluable. I mean, she's been an ice hockey game forever. She's been with deck hockey forever. She plays incredible defense. She never has enough confidence in herself. It seems like a lot of women are like that. Mm-hmm. And I don't get why that is. Like, I lose confidence in my game sometimes, but it seems like women, it's a little more like they really get down on themselves. So, Stacy shouldn't get down on herself because she's so good with her stick. Always getting in the passing lanes. Mm-hmm. And she's going to play offense on this team. I think we're going to see her get a few more points than usual. I promise you that.
Oh,
that would
be nice.
So, I mean, everybody loves Stacy. She doesn't get enough credit. She's humble about it. But I'm really looking forward to all my teams. But this team here, I'm really excited about the new talent we brought in to mix with the old and Chris Langley and goal. I expect good things. I expect to compete at a high level. We're not out here to play patty cake. Not in D5. No. Mm-mm. No. We're fucking okay. Number 4. Boozies. And I thought they were called something else out there. Boozies, but I forgot to write it down. So we'll go with Boozies. But I think it's the old Modine's team, kind of. They got James Greer, I assume, in goal. Colin Vermette, Brian Parks. If they were Modine's last year, I thought those were the coolest jerseys.
They were cool.
They were fucking awesome. Yeah. So, they got a few veteran players. I don't have much more to say about that. I don't know those guys too well, but they've always been cool. So, number 5, the Flying Peacocks. And I'm excited about this team name in general.
But the Peacocks don't play.
What they do is that holding the ball penalty. Because you're holding it, that's a 1-minute penalty if you're flying, because you gotta hold it to fly and then come down. Do you see what I'm saying? You gotta check out their logo. They got the coolest logo.
The NBC logo?
No. but I think this Josh Wells is starting. I'm not really familiar with him. I know they've been practicing left and right. But they got some talent. I think it used to be kind of on Anarchy and a couple other teams, so there should be solid. Zach Tucker, Adam Trone, Jake Waterman. I think he was stock car races too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Nice.
Mike McKeenan? Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce his last name. I know he's quite the grinder and pretty decent goal scorer too, so I'm excited to see that team. I mean, Especially that logo. I can't wait to see what their jerseys look like.
They look colorful.
The logo. Yeah, it's okay. Pretty neat. Yeah, check it out. Yeah. Nightmare on Deck Street. They are back. Vinny and Matt Garcia, of course. Adam Moore, Josh Beck, I think are kind of the usuals on that team. So,
aren't they in another division too? No.
Yes, I believe so. And it might be a different team name.
Oh, okay. Because remember we were talking about Dottie and how I thought mm-hmm. she should get the award and since she already did, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, but yeah, she'll be there. These guys on for sure too. Yep. Miles Bird, I think, might be on the team. So, I mean, they always had some scoring talent on that team and stuff. So they'll be definitely a solid team, especially down in D5. If Matt Garcia can light it up for sure. Mm-hmm. Number 7, Decades. How about this? In goal from, where the hell is he living now?
Illinois.
Moline, Illinois. Dustin Coons. So he's not wearing a Nightshades jersey in this league. That'll be quite odd.
That's going to be weird.
They have Little Squatch on their team. Hayden Hurt. Is that what you call? What do you call Little Squatch? Or
Squatch Jr. Not junior, because that'd be his kid. I don't know.
Little Squatch.
I didn't know there was a Little Squatch.
Yeah. Zara Verdeek, is that how you pronounce her name? She was on your team, right?
I think it's Verdeek, I think.
She was on your team, though, right? Mm-hmm. How's your Skittles?
Great, you want one?
Maybe later. I don't want to choke in front of the camera and die. That'd be embarrassing to die on YouTube.
That would be.
Let me die on the deck in July, which is going to be natural causes. Mm-hmm. But looks like she's got a couple other kids on her team by the looks of it, so it's gonna be a little family affair.
Looks like it.
So good luck to Dustin and Coons and Goal, man. For sure. You know, you never know what the deck kids will come up with sub wise and stuff, so this should be a fun to watch. Dustin's got a great attitude though for a goal, you know. I really like his attitude. Number 8, the 1031 Offenders. Is that a Bible verse, or is that there's like a Halloween movie?
I don't know what that would be referencing.
1031, I looked up, says glory to God.
Yeah, oh yeah.
So glory to God indeed, man. I hope you bless me, Father, with some goals this year. But here's some names. I think Adam Frederick's going to be in goal.
Oh, his dad's a pastor. Okay. That makes sense.
Okay, yeah. In which he is also listed on the team, as is Alexis. Okay. Yeah. So another
family affair.
Another family affair. That's what's cool about these leagues, man. Some of these teams come together.
Yeah, they do.
Their families and stuff and mm-hmm. kill it.
They sure do.
Was that a shot at me?
Yep.
Well done. You're learning on the fly.
I'm getting there. I learned from the best.
Cody Stallings, of course, he's quite a good little player in D5 for sure. So all the glory to God indeed for them, and good luck. I can't wait to see what their jerseys look like.
I really like the team name now. Before I was like, what does that mean? But yeah.
Yeah, and I hope I'm right for once on something.
Well, being the Fredericks, I think that would be.
All right. Yeah. They'll let us know. Alexis will let us know for sure. Number 9, Peter Savage. Poncho.
That's another good.
This is roster is very good, and a lot of it, I think, was on their 5-plus team last year, and this roster scares the shit out of me. Especially with Poncho hair.
Uh-huh.
My God, I just bitched guys. About chemo yesterday or the day before, and now I got bitch about Poncho, so don't want to run after you either. I prefer you not be around in this league. Just me. Mr. Skelly, of course, on the Mount Rushmore, Peter Savage, for sure. Great defense. He's a physical presence.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he is.
Any more you need to expand on that, I feel like. I feel like you got left the Witherspoon.
I feel like since you and Skelly are friends, I need to be on his good side and not his bad side. So.
Get to meet him, Skelly. He's a nice guy.
Stelly, I would like to meet you sometime without you stepping on me.
Ooh, stepping.
He just, like,
So you got like a little imprint on your back of your jerseys sometimes?
I still got scars on my knees from that.
I assume Johnny Fordyce is in goal. He's listed.
This one's usually goalie though, isn't he?
Well, he plays defense.
Oh, okay.
Johnny Fordyce, is there a better trash talker? Like, he makes me laugh, even the stuff he says. I love listening to Johnny. I could listen to him all day. It's hilarious. Even in goal, like, he'll turn around and talk to people in the stands
while things going on. Yeah,
I love that guy. Jeff Wersema, he's on defense, I'm assuming. He does fill in on goal on occasion. Here's a name you're familiar with, Brandon Rodriguez.
Oh, yeah.
He played with Nightshades last year. His work schedule blows, unless it's changed.
Yeah. I don't know how the firefighters play this game.
But he was great for his first year out last year.
He was.
He has speed, a good shot, and just a hell of an attitude. I don't think he said a negative word all year.
No.
I'm not sure how Nightshades lost him, but my God, what a great pickup for Pierce Savage.
Mm-hmm.
And Brooke Hammer. I mean, I've talked about her countless times, but, you know, right there with that lineup, she's going to be solid. All right, number 10. This two scares me. QC Devils, D5. Why does it scare me? Because goddamn Brian Warden's in goal.
Really?
Yes. He went and bought his pants. I'm going to play goal, Mark. I'm going to do it. Okay. And then during the last year of the season, when it ended 4+, Brian's like, yeah, I bought all my stuff because he got from Taylor Davis.
Oh, I think I remember talking about that. Yeah.
And the Devil's like, man, we really need a goalie for D5. And I think I tagged him, Brian Warden. I regret doing that. I just regret. Because you know he's going to be good.
Uh-huh.
God damn it.
Yeah.
God, Brian. So mad at you.
I wonder if he's been practicing.
I've talked to him now. I'm not going to talk to him.
Yeah, right.
I'll talk to him. How about this? Let's read off this at Oz. Lee, Jared, Gavin, Anakin. Solid, 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 and solid. Yeah, they're all damn good. Anakin's really impressed me. He really came on at the end of last year, and Gavin plays pretty damn good defense, and Lee's always had a great shot, and Jared, you know, gets after people. Here's their big gun. Eric Glasscock. You know my love affair with Eric.
Mm-hmm. Hey, look, he plays with his wife.
His wife, Emily, who's a solid player as well. You sound very bitter on a Friday night. Very bitter.
Had to have known I was going to do that when we're talking about D5.
I thought, no. Do you want me to take my show on the road? Like, I'm going to start showing up at peace with people's houses. Like in the middle of the night, just like in bed with them.
Oh, Jesus.
You know, like whoever.
You'll end up in jail.
Name a couple. Like Emily and Eric. I'm just going to show up in their bed one day. Be like, once they wake up, be like, you ready to talk dick hockey? The show's ready. Let's go. You know? Wouldn't that be cool? Instead of like Ed Sullivan show up at your door, I show up at your door. Wouldn't that be cool to take our show on the road and just show up in people's houses like, knock on the bedroom, like, let's talk dick hockey.
Yeah, but you're kind of a creep.
That's fair
enough. Especially if you showed up in their bed.
Just an idea.
Might get the cops called on you.
So, this is going to be solid. I know Brian Wooden's going to kill it, and he'll probably get rated up, so. One season.
You'd show up to Chewy's house.
I would definitely show up Chewy's house. He'd love to talk hockey.
Hey, Chewy.
Number 11, the QC Trashers D5. I thought they had the best roster last year until Todd Mitchell went down with an injury, and they lost him. That first line with him and Randy, and they had Michael Hogue at the time.
Oh, yeah.
My God, that did not feel like D5 at all. That felt like a D3. So.
We were playing against that one. Dude.
Yeah, we're trying to do a show here, kid.
Quiet.
I'm trying to live my life here.
You're going to live your life. We're talking about the Trashers here, and Brendan's listening. Brendan and goal is damn solid.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who taught him. I think Taylor Davis kind of gave him some tips.
Dang it, Taylor.
But he is very good in goal. Of course, his dad, Jamie, who's with me in Five Flaws. Hell of a shot. Yeah, he's just mastered the game. He's played it so long, you know. And I love having Jamie on board. He's such a great guy, but I don't like seeing him playing against him. Todd Mitchell, and I'm just going to put Todd and Randy together because together they're going to have maybe the top line at D5.
You know, you knew Randy before you knew that you knew him?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a long time.
Yeah, Randy Roth, Todd Mitchell, there are two players to watch. If there's an all-star game for D5, might as well pack your bags, boys. Andrew Melliker.
Really?
Yes. They just picked him up here a while back.
New
Well, not a new addition, but yeah, I mean, for this year's team, so goddamn. Cody Harkey?
Yeah.
Jesus. Jordan is conscious. Esco?
Oh, yeah.
I do not see a weak link in this team.
Yeah, me neither.
They were a pick for... They were my pick to win the title, I think, for this year. Of course, I believe on my team 100%, but they're going to be right there battling, you know, with Pierce Savage and Devils and some of these other teams.
Yeah.
I don't see a weak link. I mean, you go down Nick Hickson, another racer. Can you tell I'm getting racing fever?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, this team's going to be a problem, and they like to have a beer or two after the game. So at least if you get your ass beat, go up and have a beer or two, man. They're all good guys. Number 12, Country Financial Pickles.
The name just makes me giggle every time. It makes me laugh
every fucking time. It's great.
You can't really take that seriously.
I can't. And it's freaking awesome. That's why it's D5. That's what I love about D5, man. You don't take stuff seriously.
You don't have anybody on the roster, though.
They're not a roster listed. Couldn't tell you. They're in a pickle right now. Maybe they don't have a player.
They have a team, but nobody to play on it? Yeah.
Or they're out. Tickling the pickle. Okay. So good luck to the pickles out there. It could come out with pickle jokes all day, I'm sure. Number 13, Right Way Personal Training. That's not allowed in D5. You're not allowed to do personal training of any sort. This is D5. Take that shit up to D2 or something. Mm-hmm. We don't do that here. We're fucking lazy and old. This is what D5 is meant for. Not, oh, I lift weights. I'm going to be out there, you know.
You lift weights.
No. I need, like, Garrett Harris to show me how to lift the weights. Mm-hmm. Bo Reed, though. Mm-hmm. So, they got some players. Tyler Nels, Ethan Pearson, I think Davis Wright's in goal.
Oh, I'm assuming he owns Right Way.
Oh! Oh! That's why you're on this... You're dropping the knowledge, Jay. You're like a little Paul Rosner.
I'll never be that smart.
Well, keep striving for the stars. So good luck to them. They got a solid team for sure. Looks that way. Bull Reed will definitely lead that team. And we're finish off number 14. Nightshades.
I'm gonna give you guys a little
love too. We love Nightshades. Mainly because they run this page and they can fire at us at any time.
Jigglypuff.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite Nightshades player? No?
No.
No? Like Justin Dixon? No? Okay. Why'd you leave Nightshades? Why you left Nightshades? Holy smokes, they're the runner-ups? That's crazy, dude.
You left Nightshades, too.
We're talking about her.
We're talking about you, too.
Montana Nikolai and goal. Is she the best goalie currently going? I really don't know. I guess we'll have to get to D2 and look, you know, at their rosters and stuff. But obviously, she won the championship last year with that team, goals. Like, she covers everything from, you know, you could cross that blue line and she's out there covering. Mm-hmm. Like, she has more stoppages in play than anybody, which is great because if you're on your team, you get a fucking breather and I'm old and
I know.
Breather.
Sometimes I'm like, just hold it. Hold it.
Paul Nikolai, of course, So they're a little husband and wife action on the deck and off of it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Paul said, what'd you say? Did you say something?
I said, again.
What do you mean by that?
Husband and wife, family.
Didn't we talk about this yesterday, how some couples can play together or something?
Maybe some people need to practice playing together more.
So, Paul's a great defender. He's a lefty. And he's won a few cups. I'm counting as one of the midfield benders, even though he subbed. He helped win us that cup. He played phenomenal. He's one of the veterans of the game. Justin Dixon will be their main scorer. They're really going to need Justin to step up and score. More so than... he's a great scorer as it is. He has a great shot. He just always runs into some injury problems every now and then with his...
Yeah, take care of your knees, friend.
Take care of yourself, bud. Yeah. But then, him in D5, he's going to really light it up for sure.
Yeah.
How do you pronounce Peter's last name? Peter
Vogt.
Yeah.
I think it's Vogt.
Peter is the energizer, buddy.
Yeah.
My God, that kid
can run.
He gives me a heart attack when you're watching him on your team because you just assume he's out of place. My God, as a fan, he's one of the most fun players to watch.
He's fast and he's reckless and he's like parkour all over the deck. It's crazy.
Yeah. Kind of. So, Montana and Gola, she killed it last year for us. We're so happy to have her. That team should do some good things, man, especially Justin in that lineup. And they got some, I didn't name them, but they got some fast younger players. Schmeichel's back. And
aww.
So they got some speed, yeah.
Twinkle toes.
Yeah, man. Nightshades, they've been bringing in some better, some of the younger talent that I was talking about, like the J.J. Harpins of the world. I think Mason Rosenblum's going to sub for them. And like I said, they used to have Sam Lysak and Eddie till they had to let them go up to the upper level. So,
yeah.
Zach's been doing some pretty... Zach and Paul have been doing some pretty decent job of bringing some young talent. Fortunately, they get so good that they move up the ladder where Benches doesn't have a team. So.
Yeah.
D5 should be a good time, man. I'm looking forward to D5. I think there's just looking at it, I mean, there could be 6-7 teams for sure that could go for that title. Yeah. And this, I don't even know some of these rosters. I mean, they could be up there and I just don't even know it, you know? So just not aware of the names. And they like could the be pickles. New players. Yeah. Show me your lineup, Pickle. Show me your pickle. Don't show me your pickle. Please don't send me the video. God, I regret saying that. So tomorrow... We'll try to preview WT2, huh? Sometime or another. Maybe another bedtime edition or something, huh?
Yeah, we could do that. Yeah.
Or somehow we gotta get in. The season's starting Sunday. Couple days. It looks like mid-50s and sunny, so I'm excited about that.
Yeah, it'll be an awesome day.
Well, I'll get into all that with the WT2. I'm going to try to learn how to do a video.
Mm-hmm.
Like a montage video. I don't want to give any secrets, but I think it's going to be an all-timer. And I'm pretty proud of myself.
I know a few of them,
yeah. Yeah, so we'll see. But I also think in my head that I'm going to score like 40 goals on each team, and that's a lie. So it could be a big-ass disappointment.
I think you'll score a lot of goals.
No.
Thank you for having faith in me, kid.
Yeah.
Thank you for producing.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. You got anything more to add? How can we do today? Under an hour. Look at his fucking goal. We can do this. Yeah.
54.
Yeah. Nice. I hope everybody enjoyed that documentary last night on the deck hockey.
I came into this with the intention of doing like little 20-30 minute.
We should do like shorts. The Last Dance did, like a 10-part documentary with Paul.
That would be fun. That would
be awesome. Because, then we could break it up at least.
Yeah.
But I know he's got 10 videos in him.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. I can't wait to watch what you guys talk about after I left.
Yeah. Oh, God, he dropped the knowledge. Just dropped it. Like,
Like dropping the mic.
Yeah, and I was here for it. I'm like, I'm all ears. I already am anyways. But thank you, Josh Hellman, for this sweet ass jersey. Ours were getting pretty old before Stale. I thought once he came out with these, I'm like, you know, the ladies were checking out the other players, you know, that are hot, you know, like your Garrett Harris's of the world, or, you know, so maybe that's why he has a girlfriend now. That's uncomfortable.
You guys made a whole movie last night.
We did make a whole movie, yeah. Get your popcorn. But today, under an hour, what do you think of that?
That's still a movie.
So we got WD2, maybe in montage, and then we can take months and months off, maybe, huh? I don't know where this is going to go from here, but I'm excited.
Maybe let us know if you guys want to see more of these. If you want to see them, like, what, weekly, monthly?
I don't want to do weekly. I prefer monthly at best.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because DHF's going to get into their stuff, and I don't want to step on any toes. Oh, yeah. And if they said, Mark, I'd give you $20 just to go the fuck away and step out of a realm, I'd be all for that. I'd be at Applebee's.
Yeah. Applebee's is nasty.
Applebee's is nasty. All right. Well, thank you for tuning in. I hope you have an enjoyable weekend. I'm excited for Sunday. Until then, you ready to hit our song and close us out, producer?
Sadly.
All right. And now you're going to tell people to send in responses? I can't imagine. I can't imagine. You took out the handsome song out of it.